Ferrell are the guards, J.J. Moore and Tresan Burrell the forwards, and Chris McCullough on assignment once again from the Brooklyn Nets is the man in the middle for head coach Ronald Norris. They've had for the last couple, it is Ray McCallum and Trey Freeman in the backcourt, Zeke Upshaw, Chris Anderson, and Kevin Murphy all forwards for head coach Rex Walters. And for the home team, the Long Island Nets, who come in 4-12 overall, Donnie McGrath, Yogi Ferrell are the guards, J.J. Moore and Tresan Burrell the forwards, and Chris McCullough on assignment once again from the Brooklyn Nets is the man in the middle for head coach Ronald Norred. So just about set for tip-off between Long Island and Grand Rapids. Long Island in the home whites, Grand Rapids in their road reds. McCullough wins the opening tip, and we are underway. Thanks so much for joining us on this Thursday afternoon here in Brooklyn. It is Yogi Ferrell with it, left of the key for Long Island. Passes right side for Donnie McGrath. And up top to Tresan Burrell. Burrell had a big game on Monday against L.A. Pulls up for a right elbow jumper and knocks it down. Tresan Burrell, 14 points, 15 rebounds in the loss to the defenders. 114-106 on Monday, but he was ejected after receiving two technical fouls. First possession for Grand Rapids. It is McCallum up top for three. Knocks it down. And Grand Rapids with their first three of the ball game. Ray McCallum averaging just shy of 20 points per game on the season with the first three. It is Ferrell up top around a screen from McCullough. Down the right side, dishes for Burrell. Up top, Donnie McGrath. Back to Tresan Burrell. Crosses over down the right side of the lane. Has it stolen away by Kevin Murphy. 2-on-2 with McCallum. Dishes back to the trailing Upshaw right wing. Zeke Upshaw off to McCallum, who will call out a play for the drive. Grand Rapids coming off a big win over Raptors 905 on Tuesday at the Air Canada Center in Toronto. As it's Freeman with it left wing, dishes for McCallum. Drives baseline, dumps it off for Anderson at the rim, misses the layup, and it's rebounded by Tresan Burrell. Yogi Ferrell, skip pass left side, McGrath, pull up three-pointer off back iron, no, but an offensive rebound down to J.J. Moore, kicks out to Ferrell. Ferrell guarded by Freeman, around a screen from McCullough, bounces to him at the right elbow, fallaway jumper is short, Burrell offensive rebound, has it poked away by Freeman, but there's a foul, and it will be on Trey Freeman. Grand Rapids 8-7 on the season. That win over Raptors 905 on Tuesday, 114-87. And at the Air Canada Center, they set a D-League record for most fans ever at an NBA Development League game, 15,011, as Donnie McGrath misses a three from straight away. It was a school day game hosted by Raptors 905 on Tuesday. 3-2 our score, about 2 minutes in. Freeman with it left of the key for Grand Rapids, right side to Kevin Murphy. Goes around the screen from Anderson, down low to Anderson, bodies up McGrath, and a foul is called on Donnie McGrath. That's his first and the team's first. Chris Anderson will go to the free throw line.
Chris Anderson at the line for Grand Rapids. Two shots.
Anderson making his 13th start of the season for Grand Rapids, knocks down the first. Just over 6 points to go along with 5.7 rebounds per game. Played his college ball at Louisiana Tech. Misses the second free throw, but an offensive rebound pulled down by Upshaw. And gets it up top to McCallum. Around a screen from Upshaw. McCallum to the left elbow, backs it out left wing. He's got McCullough on a switch. Dishes up top to Murphy. He's got two to shoot. Has to throw up a straightaway three. It is short. Rebound down to McCullough. And Long Island will look to push. McGrath across the timeline. It's a screen from McCullough. Now dishes back to Chris McCullough at the right elbow. He'll shoot from there. Misses everything. And it's Kevin Murphy down with the rebound for Grand Rapids. Murphy gets a screen from Anderson. Goes right at McCullough. Fallaway jumper too strong. Rebound to Moore for Long Island. We've played about 3 minutes. Grand Rapids with a 4-2 lead. It is Ferrell around a screen from Moore. Back to J.J. Moore. Top of the key three-pointer. Rattles out. Rebounded by Grand Rapids. Long Island just one for their first six from the floor. Is Freeman a straightaway three? That rattles out. All an equally slow start for Grand Rapids. They're just one for five. McGrath, right corner three for Ferrell. Too strong. Offensive rebound Moore. Now left corner three-pointer for McGrath. That one rattles out. The Nets 1 for 8. They're 0 for 5 from beyond the arc. Slow start for both teams on the offensive end here today as Anderson cutting down the left side, finishes a layup. Chris Anderson now with 3 points, and Grand Rapids has a 6-2 lead. We've played about 3.5 minutes. Yogi Ferrell gets to the rim, but he lost it out of bounds, and it was last off of him. It was poked briefly there, I think, by McCallum, but went off the leg of Yogi Ferrell. Get a look at Zeke Upshaw, making a bit of a homecoming today for the second time. Played his college ball at Hofstra, 1 year there after 3 years at Illinois State. As it's Anderson, right block, goes right at Tresan Burrell and draws another foul. Chris Anderson will go back to the free throw line. That one's on J.J. Moore, his first and the team's second.
Chris Anderson at the line, shooting two.
First time these two teams met, Anderson 15 points, 13 rebounds. And when I spoke with Long Island coach Ronald Norred before the game, he said they let Grand Rapids in that first game kill them on the offensive glass. They had 13 offensive rebounds. Anderson had 6 of them. And he said that is going to be a main focus today, keeping Anderson off the offensive glass. Him and Chris Horton, who comes off the bench, the backup big man for this Grand Rapids Drive team. Both free throws good. It's 8-2 Drive. 4 minutes in is Ferrell down the right side. Banks one in. First two of the game for Yogi Ferrell. Coming off 22 points in Monday's loss to the LA Defenders. Guarding McCallum here. McCallum gets a screen from Anderson. Dribbles right side. Now skip left wing for Freeman. Pump fakes on a three. Pulls up from 15 and knocks it down. First two for Trey Freeman. And Grand Rapids finally starting to get a couple to go down on the offensive end. They have a 10-4 lead. Long Island just 2 of 9 from the floor to start. McGrath guarded by Ray McCallum. Gets it up top to Chris McCullough. And back to McGrath. Now around a screen from McCullough. Bounces to him down low. He draws some contact. And Chris McCullough will make Long Island's first trip to the free throw line of the afternoon. McCullough, a guy who really has consistently improved during his time in the D-League this season, playing his 14th game with Long Island this afternoon. He's played 9 with the Brooklyn Nets. As he misses the first free throw, has bounced back and forth often this season, averaging almost 20 points to go along with 8.5 rebounds per game. Makes the second, his first point of the game. And Grand Rapids doubling up Long Island right now, 10-5. We played just about 5 minutes as McCallum drives baseline. Gets it up top, Kevin Murphy for 3. Swish! Kevin Murphy's first 3. Grand Rapids out to a good start here. They've got a 13-5 lead. It's McGrath, left wing for J.J. Moore. Puts it on the floor, looking right corner for Burrell. And it was tipped by Grand Rapids. So we'll stay Long Island basketball. Timeout taken by Long Island. They trail 13-5, 6:52 to play first quarter. We'll be back on the Long Island Nets Basketball Network. 27th, the second home game in Long Island Nets history. The Drive won it 112-98. Ray McCallum had a big game for Grand Rapids. 27 points, 8 rebounds, 9 assists. Kevin Murphy added 33. Tresan Burrell, career high, 24 points, 15 rebounds. He's got an early 2 points and 1 rebound here. We'll see if he can take advantage of Grand Rapids once again as another foul is called on the Drive. And Chris McCullough will go back to the free throw line. Grand Rapids with a 13-5 lead, 6:47 to play opening quarter. McCullough 1 of 2 from the stripe on his last trip. Makes the first free throw. I was talking about his improvement earlier during his time here in the D-League this year, and what Coach Norred told me was he's not just improving on the court, but he's seen a real maturation of Chris and his ability or off the court, just the way he's getting along with his teammates, developing more of a leadership role on this Long Island team. He said he's been really proud of the way Chris has come along in that respect. Makes both free throws. It's 13-7 Grand Rapids. Jordan Crawford in the ballgame for the first time. He has been red hot for the Drive as of late, wearing number 15. He's got it. Dishes to the right block for Murphy, backing down the smaller Ferrell, and Yogi Ferrell took it away from Kevin Murphy. Here comes Ferrell in transition, bounces for Tresan Burrell, stolen away though by Zeke Upshaw, and Chris Anderson will slow it down for the Drive. Long Island already with three turnovers. It's Anderson backing down J.J. Moore, looking up top for Crawford. It ends up on the right block for Murphy, gets tied up with Moore, and a jump ball is called. Looked like it deflected off of the left hand of Trusan Burrell and then down low to Murphy, who got tied up with Moore. So Moore and Murphy will jump it up as Donnie McGrath will take a seat. Bo Beach in the ballgame. A bit of a change of the rotation for Long Island, so they've been keeping at least one of Yogi Ferrell and Donnie McGrath on the floor at all times, but it's been Yogi who's played the whole first quarter as a jump ball is grabbed by Trusan Burrell and controlled by Long Island. J.J. Moore driving baseline, bucket and one. And J.J. Moore will have a chance for a three-point play. Confused myself a bit earlier with that rotation. It is the normal rotation with Yogi Ferrell staying in the ballgame, usually for the whole first quarter. My error there is Moore with a chance for a three-point play here. And he knocks down the free throw. Long Island back within three, 13-10. Ramon Harris, Chris Horton also in the ballgame for Grand Rapids. Skip pass left side, Jordan Crawford for three. It is short and rolls out of bounds. Long Island will take over. Mentioned Crawford being red hot earlier. Scored 40 points in Grand Rapids' win over Raptors 905 on Tuesday. In just 26 minutes off the bench, he was 14 of 20 from the floor, 9 of 14 from three-point range. Bo Beach left of the key, right side to Ferrell. Drives baseline, dishes for McCullough. Up top, Bo Beach thought about a three, instead puts it on the floor. Kick out left corner, J.J. Moore buries it. Good drive and kick by Bo Beach. J.J. Moore knocks it down. And we're tied at 13. Long Island coming back after trailing by eight early. McCallum, right of the key for Murphy. Gets a screen from Horton. Murphy will try a three, off back iron, no. And Moore down with the rebound. As he'll go right to the rim by himself on the left side. Can't get it to go, but he drew a foul. Well, J.J. Moore, aggressive at the start. He's got 6 points, four rebounds. And a chance for two more here at the free throw line. Moore has really picked up his game lately, back in the starting lineup, making his seventh start of the year today as he knocks down the first. 12.5 points, just over three rebounds per game. And he misses the second, so 1 for 2 from the line for Moore. He's got a game high 7. Quickly in transition goes Murphy. Offensive foul as Moore gets back to absorb the contact and take the charge. So J.J. Moore getting involved early. He will get a rest as Carrick Felix will check in. Moore did a good job sliding with him, absorbing the contact and getting the offensive foul. So Carrick Felix playing his third game, returning from a calf injury, missed 7 games with it in the middle of the season. As Bo Beach left side, crosses over, into the lane, up and under move, lefty layup is good. Pretty move from Bo Beach, his first two. And Long Island's got their biggest lead of the game. It's at 3, 16-13. We've got about 4 minutes and change remaining here in the first as Horton down the center of the lane throws it down with the right hand. Big jam from Chris Horton brings Grand Rapids back within one. Ferrell up top. Beach steps into a three-pointer. It is short. Burrell the offensive rebound looking back up top to a cutting Ferrell. Beach keeps it in play. Grand Rapids is up with it. It is Ramon Harris. Right side Upshaw three-pointer on the way. Got it. Zeke Upshaw's first three of the game. Hit a couple of those last time these two teams played here in Brooklyn. Grand Rapids back on top, 18-16. Upshaw 4 for 9 from three, had 18 points in that first meeting as Yogi Ferrell knocks down a right elbow jumper. We're back tied up at 18. It's McCallum driving baseline, gets bumped by Felix. And out of bounds last off of Ray McCallum. Number 5 on this week's D-League Prospect Watch rankings. Was number 1 earlier in the season. Chris McCullough for Long Island. Left side, Burrell will try a 3. It's off back iron, no good. McCallum down with the rebound, and he will look to push. McCallum, Eurostep in the lane through 2 defenders, lays it in. Oh, what a pretty move from Ray McCallum. Puts Grand Rapids back on top. Yogi Ferrell bounces down low to McCullough, backing down just above the left block. He'll go one-on-one against Horton. Fall away, jumper, got it. There's the talent of Chris McCullough. A guy who's, as we said before, improving with every game, it seems like, down here in the D-League. As Horton down low off a loose ball, lays it up and in. 22-20, Grand Rapids leads under 3 minutes to play, opening quarter. It is Burrell right side, up top to Carrick Felix. Bounces left elbow to Bo Beach. Hands off to Ferrell. Yogi Ferrell will shoot from there, gets fouled, goes in and out, but Ferrell will have 2 shots when we come back. 2:31 to play, opening quarter. Grand Rapids with a 2-point lead over Long Island, 22-20 on the Long Island Nets Basketball Network. Today, they have a challenge to try to stop all 3 of those guys. They trail at 22-20, 2:31 to play in the first quarter. Yogi Ferrell at the free throw line. He knocks down the first. Talked to Coach Norred about those 3 guys before the game. Said it's going to be tough. They have to focus on getting hands up, eliminating the open perimeter jumpers, closing out the best they can, and using their offense to push the break when they can and get Grand Rapids on their heels on the defensive end. As Ferrell knocks down the second free throw, we are tied at 22. Just over 2 minutes to play, opening quarter. This is Crawford up top, crosses over against Carrick Felix. Right side, Upshaw for 3, knocks it down. Second 3 of the game for Zeke Upshaw. Grand Rapids back on top by 3. A couple of substitutions for Long Island. Lazar Hayward, Boris Dallo in the game. As Felix drives left side, draws some contact, no foul called. It's down to Ray McCallum, who will look to push. Gets it left side for Jordan Crawford. The NBA vet, guarded by Felix, pulls up from the left elbow. It is short. Bo Beach the rebound for Long Island. Outlets for Yogi Ferrell. Now Boris Dallo up top. Gets it left side to Hayward. Hayward pull up jumper from 15. Got it. Nazar Hayward had a strong game in his comeback the other day against LA after missing 13 games with a fractured right hand. Hayward off the bench, played 15 and a half minutes, had 4 points, 2 rebounds, was active as usual, down low on the offensive glass. As Upshaw dished down low for Horton at the right side of the rim, lays it in. 27-24, Grand Rapids with a 3-point lead. We've got just over a minute to play in the quarter. It's Carrick Felix, left side, Boris Dallo, open 3-pointer, off back iron, no. And Grand Rapids will look to push the break. It is Crawford at the left wing. Gets double-teamed. He'll pull it back out. Get it left elbow for Horton. Back to Crawford around a screen. Drives baseline. Is double-teamed. Skip pass for Harris. Puts it on the floor. Harris down the center of the lane. No good. But out of bounds. Last off the hands of Boris Dallo. Grand Rapids will have 5 to shoot. As McCallum will take a seat. And Trey Freeman is back in. Upshaw, up top to Crawford. Right side, Freeman, open 3-pointer, rattles out. Rebound comes down to Dallo, and Long Island will hold for 1 here, about a 8-second difference between shot and game clock. The drive have knocked down 4 of 9 threes in this first quarter. Long Island just 1 for 9. Though the Nets 7 for 10 from inside the arc, they've done most of their damage from inside the paint. As Bo Beach, left wing, 3-pointer, got it. First 3 of the game for Bo Beach. He's got 5 first quarter points. We're tied at 27. Final shot for Grand Rapids. It is Crawford going right at Felix. Kicks left corner, Freeman, open 3 at the buzzer, knocks it down. It will count. Trey Freeman at the first quarter buzzer gives Grand Rapids a 30-27 lead after one. We'll be back here for the start of the second quarter in Brooklyn. Kevin Dexter with you. Thanks for joining us, making us a part of your Thursday afternoon here on the Long Island Nets Basketball Network. McGrath, Beach, Felix, Hayward, Dallow, the five for Long Island. It's Upshaw, Horton, Crawford, Harris, and Freeman. The five for Grand Rapids. Jordan Crawford with it left side, drives baseline, kicks up top to Freeman. Swung around Upshaw, left wing three, rattles in and out. Horton, the offensive rebound, puts it back up and in. Good work on the offensive glass by Chris Horton. I mentioned it earlier, that is something that Coach Norred and Long Island really want to limit in this game if they can, as Felix's straightaway three-pointer is short. Rebound comes down to Freeman. He bounces for Crawford to Upshaw in transition at the rim. Blocking foul is called, and Zeke Upshaw will go to the free throw line to shoot two. Foul is called on McGrath, his second and the team's first in the second quarter. Not sure if his heel was on the restricted area there, but looked like he didn't quite get there in time to absorb the contact from Upshaw. Mentioned it in the first quarter. Upshaw played his college ball 3 years at Illinois State, then his senior year at Hofstra as a graduate transfer, so this is a bit of a homecoming for him, a guy who spent some time on Long Island. Had a big season there, 20 points per game, 91 made threes as a senior at Hofstra, as he makes both free throws, and he's gotten early 8 points here, a couple of threes, and those two free throws. 34-27, Grand Rapids leading as McGrath throws it off his own foot. Here comes the drive in transition. Crawford bounces for Upshaw, who lays it in, and a timeout is taken by Ron Norred. 36-27, the drive with a 9-point lead over the Nets. They score the first six here in the second. We'll be back on the Long Island Nets Basketball Network. Away from home, I asked Coach Norred about it before the game, if he realized how many games they're going to have at home here upcoming over the next couple of weeks and if they want to take advantage of it. And he honestly didn't even realize. You know, you joke a lot about basketball coaches and basketball players being so locked in, as Burrell knocks down a free throw line jumper, to just game by game, taking it one game at a time. And they truly do, as Coach Norred said, I didn't even think about that we've had so many so many games upcoming here at home over the next couple of weeks. So Burrell snapping the Grand Rapids run. It is Upshaw right wing for the drive, gets it right corner. Three ball on the way, rattles out from Ramon Harris. And Hayward down with the rebound for Long Island. Gets it up top to Donnie McGrath. Around a screen from Hayward. Moore driving baseline. Layup no good. Rebound pulled down by Horton. Another aggressive move, though, from J.J. Moore. He's looked for his own shot to start this ball game as Harris steps into a left-wing three-pointer. No good. Follow-up jam from Chris Horton. Oh, a big two-handed jam from Horton on the offensive glass. 38-29, Grand Rapids leading Long Island. 2 minutes into the second quarter. McGrath pull up three ball. It is short. Hayward gets pulled there by Freeman, but no whistle on the play. It is Crawford left side. Crosses over. Crawford to the rim. Layup is good. Jordan Crawford, his first two, coming off a 40-point game on Tuesday. And Grand Rapids win over Raptors 9:05 is Hayward straightaway three ball off back iron, no good, and it's Upshaw with the rebound. The drive with their largest lead of the game right now, it's at 11. Freeman around a screen from Horton, pulls up from 20, it is short. It's pulled down by Hayward, up ahead J.J. Moore by himself will lay it in. The Grand Rapids side arguing for a foul on that last play, as it is Freeman across the timeline, right side to Upshaw. He'll dribble up top, guarded by Hayward. Gets it left side to Crawford. Bounces for a cutting Horton. Left the layup short. McGrath down with it. Long Island's got numbers. Left side for Moore, who throws it down with the right hand. Good find from Donnie McGrath. Big jam from J.J. Moore. He's in double figures with 11. And Long Island is back within seven. Horton guarded by Bo Beach. Hands off for Crawford. Jordan Crawford spinning in the lane, dishes back to Harris, right side Freeman, back to Crawford in the right corner for three. It's too strong. Jordan Crawford, 1-for-4 from the floor to start. As Hayward down the right side of the lane, swung around up top to McGrath, who steps into a three. It goes in and out. And the rebound pulled down by Grand Rapids. We've played about 16 minutes in this game, under 8 to play, second quarter. Grand Rapids with a 40-33 lead over Long Island. Harris, right side to Upshaw. Kicks out left corner to Freeman for three. It's good. Second three of the game for Trey Freeman. He's got 8 points. And the Grand Rapids lead is back out to 10. J.J. Moore looking down low to Hayward. He got held by Horton. Foul is called on Chris Horton. Get another look at the big jam from Horton. On the offensive glass, J.J. Moore also threw down a big dunk just about a minute later. Off the nice find from Donnie McGrath. As Chris McCullough, Tresan Burrell, Yogi Ferrell, all back in the game for Long Island. They've got their starting five out there. As Ferrell left side, dishes right wing for McGrath. He'll back it out. Bounces to McCullough, try to give and go as McGrath got bumped. But he won't get the whistle. Murphy, Anderson, McCallum back in for Grand Rapids. And Terrence Jennings in for the first time, wearing number 34. He's a guy who was not on the Grand Rapids roster. First time these two teams played. Was claimed by the drive from the available player pool on the 11th of December. McCallum left side. Hands off for Freeman. Around a screen from Jennings. Now gets it to Jennings in the lane. Dishes off for Anderson for the two-handed jam. Nice find from Jennings. And Grand Rapids now with their largest lead at 12. It's 45-33. Get a look at Grand Rapids head coach Rex Walters, a former draft pick of this Nets organization, of the New Jersey Nets back in 1993. And it's J.J. Moore up top, left side to Burrell. Burrell up top, right side Ferrell. Good look at a three, got it. Yogi Ferrell's first three of the game. He's got 9. Brings the Nets back within 9. The Nets just 3-for-15 from beyond the arc in this game. They've taken more than half of their attempts from deep, 15 of their 29 field goal attempts, but they are 10-for-14 from inside the arc. Much more success in the paint in this ballgame as Jennings, a floater, is good. Extending the lead back out to 11. It's McCullough up top. Steps into a three ball. That one is short. J.J. Moore, the offensive board. Kicks out to McGrath. Up top, Ferrell. He'll drive it down the left side. Throws it up high for Burrell, who lays it in. Pretty feed from Yogi Ferrell. Tresan Burrell's first points in a while. He's got 6. And Long Island once again within single digits. And an offensive foul is called on Anderson. First personal called on Anderson. Long Island has played their best basketball of the season as of late. Again, coming off a loss here at Barclays Center to LA on Monday, a game which they executed poorly down the stretch. Is Moore down the right side of the lane. Layup no good. McCullough offensive rebound, couldn't get it to go. Burrell stole it away, got it down low to Moore. And J.J. Moore, once again, he's got 13 points. Off the feed from Tresan Burrell. Around a screen from McCullough. Dishes down low, another foul called. This one is on Jennings.
Grand Rapids foul number 34, Jennings, his first personal. He's second.
Back into the game for Grand Jordan Rapids. Crawford will come back in, replacing Trey Freeman.
Number 10, Trey Freeman.
Left wing three ball from Moore is short. And here comes Grand Rapids in transition. McCallum left side, guarded by McGrath. Looking down low to Crawford. Got a big size advantage on Yogi Farrell. Kicks out to Murphy, left wing, long two. Off back iron, no. Out of bounds, last off of Anderson.
That's ball.
And Grand Rapids is given a warning. I didn't like that last call. So the officials giving them a warning. Grand Rapids with a 7-point lead, 47-40. 4.5 minutes to play, second quarter. And it's Farrell across the timeline, down the left side of the lane, dumps it off for J.J. Moore, who lays it up and in. 15 points for J.J. Moore. He's had a huge first half. Farrell picks up the assist, his second. Brings Long Island back within five. Trying to channel some of this momentum as Crawford splits two defenders and lays it in. Oh, what a pretty move from Jordan Crawford. It's Grand Rapids back out to a 7-point lead. It's the kind of things that Crawford can do, a guy who's played 257 NBA games in his career as Moore misses a short jumper. Here comes McCallum the other way. Pulls up from 15, knocks it down. Fadeaway jumper from Ray McCallum, who has been a bit quiet, though he's made every shot he's taken so far. Got 7 points, 3 of 3 from the floor. One of those a three-pointer. Donnie McGrath at the left elbow for Long Island. Gets it to Tresan Burrell. Left elbow jumper is good. A couple of elbow jump shots in this game from Tresan Burrell, starting to get more confident with his jump shot. Guy who's so active on the offensive glass, probably the best athlete on this Long Island team, the way he can jump and his quickness on the defensive end. So it's Crawford up top, guarded by Farrell. Gets a screen from Upshaw, had it poked away by Moore. And it was last off of Jordan Crawford, so the Nets will have it after the timeout. Nets home games, and five of them will be in the first 2 weeks of January, so we will get an extended look and see how that works. As always, the D-League, a ground for testing for the NBA, so get a chance to test that out, see how it works out, and if they want to implement it into the NBA, maybe sometime in the future, as Moore gets fouled driving on the baseline by Zeke Upshaw. Moore, 15 points, 5 rebounds to lead the way for Long Island in this one. Upshaw and Horton each have 10 for Grand Rapids. Yes, yes. McGrath up top, around a screen from McCullough, gets it to Moore, down low to Chris McCullough. Backing down Harris as McCullough the hook shot. Offensive rebound pulled down by Burrell, back to McCullough who throws it down. Tresan Burrell again active on the offensive glass. Brings Long Island back within 5, 51-46. Jordan Crawford, right side to Upshaw, puts it on the floor. Kicks out Harris, left wing three ball, rattles out. Saved from going out of bounds by Yogi Farrell. And he will bring it across midcourt. Farrell gets a screen from Moore. Swung around to Burrell up top. His three ball off back iron, no good. And now McCallum to a cutting Upshaw. Hop step in the lane, gets fouled by Burrell.
That's foul number two, Tresan Burrell. He is first personal. Team second.
First personal on Burrell, team second.
It's the Nets' first foul in the last 2 minutes. Zeke Upshaw shooting two.
Upshaw has had a strong first half for Grand Rapids. Now make it 11 points as he knocks down the free throw. Jennings back in the ball game. For the drive, he will replace Murphy. As Upshaw knocks down the second. It's a 7-point Grand Rapids lead, 53-46. Just over a minute and a half to play in the first half. McGrath gets a screen from McCullough, kicks out right side. Burrell swung around right corner. Moore for three. It is short. McCallum down with the rebound. And Ray McCallum looking for Harris in the left corner. Had it stolen away by Moore. Moore to Burrell to a cutting McCullough who throws it down. Oh, that was a pretty play from Long Island. Tic-tac-toe passing. And Chris McCullough finishes it off. Upshaw up top for Grand Rapids as we have under a minute to play in the half. Had it stolen away by McCullough briefly. Back up with it, though, was Jennings for Grand Rapids and a collision between Jennings and Moore. They both go down hard.
That's foul number 44, J.J. Moore, his second personal.
Foul is called on Moore, his second. And the team's second foul in the final 2 minutes, so it will be Jennings to shoot two.
Harris Jennings at the line for Grand Rapids. Two shots.
First free throw, no good. And he misses the second. Long Island with a chance to get this back to a one-possession game. It is McGrath. Gets a screen from Moore. Dishes for McCullough. Back to Donnie McGrath. He'll pull up from 18. A little bit too strong. Rebounded by Harris. Nearly threw it away, but got it to Jennings. And Crawford will bring it across the timeline. Jordan Crawford down the left side of the lane, right to the rim, lays it in. Jordan Crawford's got six. Been a bit quiet for his standards in this opening half. As Long Island will hold for one, a 7-second difference between shot and game clock. Down to 10 to shoot. It's Chris McCullough, drives at Jennings, lefty floater no good. Rebounded by Harris, and Ray McCallum will bring it across the timeline. Gets it into the right corner for Crawford. And he gets fouled by J.J. Moore, and Jordan Crawford we'll have two free throws here before the end of the half. First free throw good from Crawford. He knocks down the second. One final shot. Coming for Long Island, it is Farrell. Pulls up for a left-wing three-pointer off back iron, no. And Grand Rapids will take a 9-point lead.